Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Cabral Concept. I appreciate you joining me here today on this Wellness and Weight Loss Wednesday, where the goal is to be able to help you transform your body and maintain a healthy weight the healthy way. That's really what it's all about, is that there's no true shortcuts to success, as they say. However, if you're following a tried and true proven formula, you will get there the fastest way possible. And again, if we're talking about weight loss, we've seen people lose in a healthy way 15 pounds, sometimes even more, in just 21 days. And the reason is that they're doing it by rebalancing their hormones, by rebalancing their estrogen dominance, by rebalancing their adrenal output in terms of stress hormones. They're rebalancing healthy levels of blood sugar and so much more. So remember, weight loss is just not one particular silver bullet approach. It is a multifactorial approach. That is the way that you're always going to get the best results. But as we do know, one of the issues with going on a diet or exercising or trying to lose the weight and get in better shape is sometimes you derail your progress by overeating at a meal or overeating for that day. So there's just a couple things I want to say about that before I go into the three big mistakes that I see happen in my own life and for others as well. And the first one is this. So I mean, this is really important. Before we get into the mistakes, let me just share with you this, that if you ever overeat, it's okay. Honestly, it's okay. Your body's going to rebound most likely from that meal in about 3 hours. Why do I say that to you? It's because you didn't ruin your whole day and you didn't ruin your whole week and you didn't ruin your whole diet plan. All right. That goes whether someone's on the CBO protocol or they're on our Fatlocity plan or they're doing the functional medicine detox that we do over at Equal Life. It's fine. Honestly, it's okay. Nobody's perfect. You don't want to try to make a habit of it, but you don't want to just say, oh, I blew it. The whole day is gone. Let me just go eat. What are some of my favorite childhood foods? We were talking about this the other day. Raspberry Twinkies or Devil Dogs or, you know, Fruity Pebble cereal. You don't go back and just don't, you know, just say, okay, well, today's ruined. I'll start tomorrow. No, don't do that. Because remember, the effects is only going to be about 3 hours. And the nice thing is, if you exercise that day, you're going to be able to return your blood sugar to normal faster, especially if it's after one of those overeating times, or you're going to create a little bit of a deficit in it anyway. So honestly, don't worry about it. Get back on track right away. Tomorrow is always a new day. Get back on track. That's what it's all about. But hopefully we never get to the point of overeating, unless of course it is your flex meal and you're giving yourself that time to do that, which is okay as well. Again, remember, once you're making progress, we typically say after 3 week functional medicine detox, after 3 weeks on Fatlocity, the phase one, then good. Go and have yourself a weekly flex meal and you can enjoy your favorite foods at that meal. Remember, it's only going to be about a 3 hour rise in glucose and hopefully your body brings that back down. Yes, the inflammation will last the next 24 hours. There's no doubt about that. But what we're saying is, if we're talking about body transformation, your body will be able to recover. Okay. So you're going to be able to do this. And what I would say to you right now is, let's focus on three ways that this will most likely happen to you in your life and cause you to overeat. Because again, we've worked with over a quarter of a million people. And I say that it's because we have so much data. There are very few studies with anywhere near a quarter of a million people. Most studies, 56 people, 12 people, maybe 100 people. I like to look at studies with more than 1,000 people. We literally have over 20 years and a quarter million people of data. We've got a lot of research on our part. So I want to share with you, though, just three simple things. They're not out of control, and you probably have done them yourself, but what you have to do is recognize them ahead of time, and that will prevent you from overeating. All right. So the first one is this: fatigue. If you wake up feeling tired, what happens to the body? It's looking for two things mainly: sugar and caffeine, which is why the most popular drug or supplement, however you want to look at it, in the world is caffeine. It's coffee, right? Or tea. It is some type of black tea or coffee to stimulate the body. What does that do? Well, it gives you artificial energy. So it gives you a little spike of norepinephrine and cortisol to get that body going. All right. And so again, this doesn't mean that it's necessarily a bad thing. We want to be able to have coffee in a healthy way. If you choose to have a cup of coffee in the morning, great. As long as it's not causing a sharp spike in blood sugar, kicking you out of the fasted state. If you're doing that, that it's not typically first thing on an empty stomach. You want to do a couple things before that I've talked about in other shows so that you hydrate your body, you stabilize your body before you put in a somewhat dehydrating beverage. So it's really important. But, you know, being tired and going for coffee is only one thing. One of the reasons why people love to put cream and sugar in their coffee or sugar in their coffee is because now they're getting their spike in glucose, right? So that's going to give short-term energy and they get the caffeine. And believe it or not, one of the fastest ways, like a fast way to restore glycogen stores, believe it or not, is adding caffeine. I learned this many years ago when I was first getting into sprint triathlons. I learned that a faster hydration method is actually to mix some type of sugary beverage. Now, again, you don't have to do this, of course. You could simply have some fruit or whatever you'd like. But you mix it with caffeine and you mix it with sodium. And that allows for a greater uptake of that glucose to be turned into glycogen, or most likely if you're doing athletics, it's going to be used as a fast fuel right away. So it's just a faster emptying through the stomach and through the first part of the small intestine. So just want to share that with you. Your body's programmed. It's hardwired for these things if you're tired. Now, if you're not as tired, you're not going to be reaching for the caffeine and for the sugar for that fast pick-me-up. Really important to look at that. But just as important if you get an afternoon crash, because an afternoon crash is going to do what? Well, it's going to cause you to then look for that snack mid-afternoon and if you're on a body transformation plan, you really don't want to be snacking. You honestly don't. And I've got many podcasts on that. I've got a podcast on why 3 meals per day. I'm going to link that up here for you today. So go to stephencabral.com/2035 for additional podcasts and tips from today's show. So fatigue is a big one. Remember, if your body's tired, it's going to look for carbohydrates. It's going to look for some type of food. A lot of times salt. Why would it look for salt? Salt is used by the adrenals. It's technically used by a specific hormone called aldosterone. You could look at that as a hormone. You could look at it as a neurotransmitter. You could look at it as an electrolyte balancer. But essentially what it's doing is it's telling the body to hold on to a little bit more sodium, gives you a little bit of a boost because it gives you a little bit of an increase in blood pressure. That's going to help you get things done. So again, remember, your body knows what it's doing. But if you stabilize blood sugar with a healthy breakfast, a healthy lunch, a healthy dinner, you're going to be doing much better. And yes, you can still fit in a 12, 14, or 16-hour intermittent fast and still eat 3 meals per day. It's absolutely possible. Again, we have people doing it all the time and still able to transform their body the healthy way. So watch for fatigue. Be careful with that. Get your sleep. Don't overdo it. And if you are tired that day, just know ahead of time that your body's going to be looking for more food. You don't need to give it more food. You can give it a little bit more water, a little bit more hydration, right? So keep some water around at all times and you'll be able to hydrate. All right, the second mistake that may cause you to overeat is fasting too long, right? This is a big one. Now, hear me out here for one second. Let's say that you're someone that typically goes from 6 o'clock at night till 12 the next day. All right, so let's say that you're doing, 18 hours? Is it 18 hours? Yes, it's 18 hours. Sorry, the math with here was confusing me for a moment. 6 to 12 at night is 6, plus another 12 is 18. So let's say you're someone that's doing that long of a fast, or maybe it's 16 hours, you're going from 8 at night to noon to lunch. But let's just say anyway, you're fasting till lunch. Okay, so a lot of people are fasting till lunch. I'm not against that for everyone, but I can tell you for sure, I was one of the very first people to share with you that it affects stress hormones, it affects thyroid, and it can actually hurt your metabolism in the long run, especially with women. And I was sharing this 5-6 years ago when nobody was talking about it. Now, luckily, we have people starting to talk about it. And the reason is, though, keep in mind, I'm a clinician first. I run tens of thousands of labs per year. So I get to see just lots of data. So I say, oh, this is what happens with not everyone, but some people, many people that fast too long. Oh, they start to get thyroid issues. They start to get estrogen dominance. They start to get lower levels of cortisol in the morning, feel a little bit groggy, but then they can't sleep at night. We call that tired and wired. So all sorts of issues. Again, not for everyone, but some people. That's why there's no all for one. But here's the thing. What a lot of other people do, though, is they fast until lunch, yet they then overeat at lunch because they're so hungry. They're literally, as they say, starving. Technically, you're not starving, but your body's quite hungry. So what happens is then you end up eating the same amount of calories that you would have at breakfast and lunch if you combine them, but you're just doing it at lunch. So now you're creating a lot of gastric distress on your stomach because instead of eating maybe 500 calories at lunch, you just ate 1,000 calories, right? So just kind of keep in mind that you can't really cheat the system. Again, you can absolutely do 12, 14, 16-hour intermittent fast. I'm not saying you can't. You just have to do it in a normal physiological manner because you can't trick your body. So if you're someone that tends to overeat when you don't eat, you know, for a period of time, you have to be careful with that because that's causing then more gastric distress, more inflammation, and certainly causing you to overeat, which isn't good for your digestive tract as well. So just want you to keep that in mind. I call it the rebound effect from not eating. Now, again, I will say this. I do a 24-hour fast once a week. I go from Sunday night. I have a nice dinner with my family, getting ready for the start to the week. And then it's Monday. Mondays are super busy for me. I literally have meetings from 10 a.m. until about 5 o'clock. And I have a couple hours of catch-up work in the morning. And then I'm off to the races with my teams. I've got great, great teams. And we connect and we talk about the week and all that good stuff. But I'm busy all day long. And so it's a great day for me to do a 24-hour fast. Now, am I hungry during that time? Sure. I get hungry around 10 a.m. and then again at like 3 or 4 o'clock. And so what does that mean? Well, here's the thing. And I do this about 3 out of 4 Mondays a month. And again, go back to why I do this and the different 4 different types of fasts, because there's much more information on this. I can't get so nuanced today. But why don't I overeat then at dinner? Because, you know, typically I'm eating probably somewhere between 2,400 and 3,000 calories a day. I eat a good amount of calories. One is that I'm more of the ectomeso body type. So my body is burning a lot of calories. I'm also exercising 5 days a week. And I have even though I'm sitting down a lot of the day, I make sure that I'm standing throughout the day. And also I'm very busy cognitively and working at work. So I'm always talking, I'm always moving, I'm leading my team. And so there's a lot of energy expended. So you have to understand it's different calories for different people. Anyway, what I want to share with you is this, but when I go and do my 24-hour fast, I might have 1,000 calories at dinner. There's no doubt about that. But I'm not eating 2,500 calories. So I'm not overeating at dinner. Why? Because I know what I was just going through. I know why I was going through it and specifically what I was doing it for. And this is very important. I knew that I would get hungry throughout the day. I knew ahead of time, because I've done this before, that this is what's going to happen. And if you know ahead of time, then you can relax into it. You can breathe into it. You can have some good water, some herbal teas, things like that. You can do your straight DNS if you want. I talk about that. It's called my 1-day reset diet. Check that out. It's an easy way to get into this type of fasting. So that's that. I'll keep it at that. Again, many other shows besides that. But again, it's knowing and being aware, oh, I'm going to be hungry today if I'm doing my once a week fast, or we do a quarterly fast, which is our functional medicine detox. We actually have one coming up this September 20th, I believe. And so you have to understand for the first 2 days, liquid, right? Liquid. And there's a very specific reason we do that, of course, creating autophagy, stabilizing blood sugar, hormones, etc. Anyway, if you know ahead of time, this is what's coming, it allows you then to not overeat. It's when it sneaks up in you, you weren't prepared for it, then you end up overeating, right? Okay. The last one is this. This is a big one as well. Okay. Fasted workouts. It means going into a workout fasted and hungry. Okay. Let me add a couple nuances, a couple caveats to this. I am not against fasted workouts by any stretch of the imagination. I actually recommend fasted workouts for people looking to lose weight. And I recommend fasted workouts for people with higher levels of glucose, fasting glucose. However, what I typically recommend is AM fasted cardio rather than driving the body too hard with a resistance training workout. Now, can you do a resistance training workout in the morning? Of course you can. No doubt about it. There's no doubt about it. But if I'm looking to rebalance someone's blood sugar, I'm doing cardio over weight training. Again, you can prove this for yourself with a continuous glucose monitor that I believe I'm reviewing next Friday. So stay tuned for that. That will be coming out, yes, next Friday. So definitely check that out. I've got a great one. I've been using it now for a couple of weeks. Phenomenal. Well, I mean, way better than the old school one that I used to use to track blood sugar. Excuse me. But that's a great way to lower glucose levels. But the other thing is this. So again, no problem with fasted workouts, none at all. And especially if you're fasted workout, like I do one at let's say 4:30 PM. Okay, but I'm having dinner afterwards and I had lunch before. So yes, I'm fasted, but I've already eaten that day. I'm talking about more like a lot of times an AM one, or let's say you do an AM one and then you fast before your workout and you fast after your workout and then you don't eat till lunch. A lot of people are doing this to try to maximize fat burning, right? Well, it can work unless that workout spiked your blood sugar. And again, unless you're testing your blood sugar, even just with a glucometer, then you don't necessarily know. So little caveat right there, but I'll tell you this. Again, nothing wrong with fasted workouts. Not great for people with low blood sugar, that's for sure. Not great for Vata body types. Not great for those people that have more anxiety, that run a little bit hot in terms of the metabolism, because now you're taking a catabolic person and driving them even further catabolic. So keep that in mind. But for those people looking to lose body fat, looking to stabilize blood sugar, can be great. What you want to watch out for, though, is a rebound effect here as well. If you're burning more calories, and you've already been fasted, your body's like, what is going on here? You just made me use up my glucose reserves. We haven't had any food in 12, 14, 16 hours or so. And now you're asking me to expend even more energy? Where is this energy going to come from? And it's going to tell you, you need to eat more food the next time you have food available to you. So just be careful for that one. Again, you can still eat your normal food and calories during the day. Just have to be careful. You do that fasted cardio and you do that fasted workouts, it may sneak up on you. But again, as long as you're aware of it, you are ready for it. And that's a great thing, because if you're aware and you're ready for it, you can stay with your plan. That's really what it's all about. And the last thing I'll give you is this: in order not to overeat, what you want to be able to do is have a plan going into the day. This is when my exercise is. This is when my meals are. These are what my meals are going to consist of. And if you're not bringing them from home, where you're going to go to get those meals. And if you're not able to go to that place, what is your backup spot? That is one that people overlook. You know, if you're going out for lunch and you only have a half hour and the line's out the door at your favorite salad place or whatever it might be, what's your backup? Is your backup, you don't have one? Oh, so you're eating pizza or a sandwich or fast food on the run? That's not good. So we have to have a backup besides that. Now, maybe it's just one of these, you know, organic whole food bars, or it's something like that. You have to have a backup for the plan in case it doesn't go according to plan, because if not, you're eating where you shouldn't, you're overeating. It's not a good idea. So again, in time, you'll be able to master all of these things. Remember, losing the weight and keeping it off and maintaining a healthy physique is something that happens over time. You learn the lessons, you learn what works well for your body, you're able to adapt, and of course, then you get to enjoy your favorite foods as well. That's really what it's all about. So if I can help in any way, just let me know, reach out. Feel free to join CabralSupportGroup.com. That's our free private Facebook group. Well over 12,000 people from all over the world have joined, never advertised, never marketed. These are like-minded people trying to transform their health. They're trying to lose the weight if they need to, and they're working on anti-aging based protocols. Great people from all around the world. Definitely connect with them. And again, if you're interested in learning more about the functional medicine detox, our Fatlocity system, all the free intermittent fasting podcasts, we'll link them all up, and that'll be at stephencabral.com/2035. Thanks so much, everyone. I appreciate you. Take care. And of course, feel free to share this show with anyone you believe it could serve.